Schrock Innovations presents the Midwest number one independent computer repair company with service centers in Lincoln, Omaha, Papillion, Des Moines, and across the country via the Schrock Desk. This is Compute This.
Good morning, folks, and welcome into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company. We have four locations to help you out when your computer's not working, or maybe your hard drive has failed, you need to get that data back off of it. If you need a new computer, new laptop, new desktop, or even a custom-built gaming system, we handle it all at Schrock Innovations. The OG Schrock Innovations, we got the whole thing started in Lincoln, Nebraska. We are just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road in Lincoln. In Omaha, 168th and Burke Street, across the street from the Village Point Mall. The third location came in Papillion in 2011, actually, 84th and Highway 370 in the Midlands Place Shopping Center there. It's tucked back in that little business park there, but, man, just some amazing neighbors through there. We got Ollie and Hobbs in there, great place to eat. Spin Pizza's in there, good stuff there as well. And, you know, Sport Clips, you get a good haircut, too. So, you know, you got everything you need right there. And, of course, the newest location, 9500 University Avenue in West Des Moines, Iowa. Elias transferred from our Lincoln Service Center to take over management of the Des Moines Service Center. He actually moved to Des Moines. And I popped in and did a surprise visit, which it wasn't a huge surprise. I mean, he kind of knew I was going to come. But you see, my son, he's trying to get his driver's license. And he needs to have 10 hours of nighttime driving. So he's like, hey, Dad, can we run the transfer to Des Moines? And maybe we leave around 3, you know, so the trip down there is daylight and then the trip back is dark. And he did really good. He did really, really good. So we went down there and, got to take a look. And I just have to say, Elias is doing an amazing job in that service center. The Des Moines Service Center has so much opportunity. So many people in that area need a computer repair service center. We're right beside Waukee there. I mean, it's just an amazing part of town. We tried to find a parking spot in our own parking lot, you know, at 6 o'clock, and because of all the restaurants and everything in that area, the parking lot was literally completely full. My son, it was a great experience for his driving. Had to park pretty much in a snowbank between two cars. So I'm like, hey, this is good parking practice because they're going to make you park the car at the end of the driver's test. That's where I failed my first driver's test. Yeah, that's right. My first driver's test, I took it when I was 18, and I got in an accident during the driving test. And then I had the audacity to ask if I passed. Yeah, it started to sleet while I was driving. And anyway, that's a story for the aftershock. We'll save that one for later. 402-558-1110 is the number to join us on the program. If you're outside the metro area, you can call in toll-free 888-250-2091, 888-250-2091. As we do every week, we'll be giving away a $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate, good for anything your heart desires over at the service center. It's literally cash in your Schrock account. And that way, when you come in for your next maintenance checkup or you need to renew your Sophos or whatever you need to do, that money is sitting there waiting for you in your Schrock account, and it's automatically applied. You don't have to remember to ask for it or anything. So it's a great deal, and all you have to do to get in on that drawing is give us a call here on the show, be a part of the program, ask a question, make a comment. Trust me, guys, if you have a question, there are tons of people out there that have the same question. We've been doing this show for over 20 years. What tends to happen, you know, from my perspective, the question's like, I already answered that question. But from your perspective, you could be new to the program. Maybe you've only been here for 5 years. You know, you missed the first 15 years of questions. There could be all kinds of things that you don't know or you want to know about your computer. And if you have the question, lots of other people have it as well. So be the person that calls in, win yourself, you know, $25 in the process, and help a whole lot of people out. All right, so last week, if you missed the show last week, you can check it out at schrockinnovations.com. Just click on radio show, and you can find not only last week's main program, but also the Aftershock, both video and audio. The Aftershock is a special little program we do after this show. It kicks off about 5-6 minutes after the top of the hour here, and we use that to contain all of the little random neural firings that happen in my brain during the radio show that tend to get me off track, you know, like telling stories about my first driving test. You know, it's completely not related to anything. That's what the Aftershock is for. So you can check that one out coming up here on the program. But last week on the main show on Compute This, we told you about a special laptop that we had over at Schrock. It's basically one of we ordered some Gallant laptops. And we get them in, of course, we modify them. Well, The supplier who was selling us the Gallant laptops ran out of the ones that we wanted with the Ryzen 5 processor in them, so they just sent us i5s instead. And these have touchscreens, so they probably figured, they're a better laptop. They're touchscreen. It's got an i5 processor in it. I'm sure they'll be fine. Well, it doesn't have a backlit keyboard, and, you know, we kind of have catalogs that say we have backlit keyboards. It's on the website. Customers expect it. We can't just change it up for no reason, even though we have a little asterisk that says we can. You know, we don't want to do that. We just kept getting these laptops over and over. We had five of them. We started to send the rest of them back because we're like, listen, we can't just keep getting these in. Well, we marked them down $100, so they're $100 cheaper than a Gallant. Because the first five that we got, we had already opened and we had already modified before my guys told me, hey, these aren't a perfect match to what we need. And well, we'd already done all the work. There was, you know, let's go ahead, mark them down $100, put them up for sale. We had five to start. We have one left. So if you're looking for a good deal on a laptop and you want that touchscreen and you want a good, fast processor and a lot of storage, the Gallant laptop is the way to go. $100 off, one left. You can order it online at schrockinnovations.com. Just click on shop and then specials. Or you can just call the service center. We open at noon in Omaha Lincoln Papillion. Des Moines is closed just like Chick-fil-A on Sundays. So you call any of the service centers. We can transfer it anywhere that you want us to transfer it to if you want to pick up that last one there. We let you know last week that the police can no longer automatically request your Ring video doorbell video anymore. They can't send a pop-up to you saying, can you share this with law enforcement? They have to actually come knock on your door and ask you now. So that's something new there that we told you about. Also, we told you that all the people who are freaking out about AI taking their job, you got some time. Because you see, the thing that nobody considers is AI is incredibly expensive to implement. So if you're a company and you're looking at your quarterly gains, well, it's going to take you 3 or 4 quarters to really fully implement AI and see a return on investment. Well, you could get away with much better gains over the next 4 quarters by just keeping the humans instead. So you got a little bit of time before AI comes for your job. Also, we told you that it was good to go to install iOS 17.3 on your Apple devices. No issues or problems reported with that at all, which is amazing because there's always an issue or a glitch or a problem or something. But 17.3 looks pretty solid. So go ahead and install that if you haven't done so already. All right. So coming up on the program today, we have a lot of AI-related things to talk about. And we're going to frame it in the framework of security. Because you can talk about AI and, you know, at Hy-Vee, you know, when you're going and scanning your groceries now, the camera is watching your hand motions to see if you pass something over the scanner, but the scanner doesn't beep. Now, the problem is sometimes it detects your hand after you pick it up on your right, you pass it over the scanner toward your left, beep, and then you put it in the bag. And then you move your hands back the other direction. Well, sometimes when you're moving your hands back, it detects that as you passing something over the scanner, and it didn't beep. And then it's like, oh, you didn't beep that. But I didn't have anything, but you didn't beep that. And then the computer gets confused. So there's AI like that that we're dealing with in the world right now. But there's AI involved behind the scenes, not only in the security software that keeps your computer safe and tries to automate your defenses, if you will, to keep you safe and keep you from making wetware mistakes, you know, from you getting tricked, basically. But now the bad guys are also using AI to implement more and more sophisticated attacks on your technology. So we're going to talk a little bit about that today. We're also going to wrap this into a special offering that we're going to have this month at Schrock Innovations. If you listened to the Aftershock last week, I kind of gave you a heads up about it, but our Sophos antivirus, it's AI-powered antivirus. This is literally one of, if not the best security solution you can have on your computer. The version that we sell is the corporate version of Sophos antivirus. This is the same thing if you were a Fortune 500 company, you would be running on your computers to keep your computers safe for all your employees. Basically, what we tell Sophos is we are the Fortune 500 company, and we have thousands of employees. That's you. And we're going to keep all their computers safe. Those are your computers and your phones and your tablets and everything else. If you buy the home version of Sophos, you get a similar technology with far less AI integration. And, of course, no custom group policies or anything like that. When you get it from Schrock, there's all kinds of add-ons. We're going to go into that a little bit that you get for free. You don't pay extra for it. Now, the trade-off here, though, is, you know, if you get, you know, ye olde Norton antivirus or maybe McAfee, you're going to pay, you know, $40, $50, $60 a year, maybe for a renewal. And you can run it on up to 9,900 computers at one time. Isn't that great? Maybe you're getting your antivirus protection free from your internet service provider. Maybe they're providing Cox or CenturyLink or Quest or Charter. Maybe they're giving you something as part of your subscription to keep your computer free from viruses and malware. We're going to tell you why they do that, what it actually protects on your computer, more importantly, what it doesn't protect, and what the motivation is for giving that to you for free. Because as we all know from this program, over years and years and years, there is no free lunch. If you're not paying for the product, you are the product. That's what this is about, right? So we're going to go into that a little bit on the program today as well. A couple weeks ago, we talked about how Firefox seems to be dying. Their market share has dropped to 2%. It seems to be a nonprofit organization that exists to pay the CEO millions of dollars a year for running a browser company that has 2% market share, literally living off of license fees that Google pays so that they can use the old Netscape-related patents inside of Google Chrome. Well, there's a new browser on the market, and by no means is it a roaring huge new browser that's taking tons of market share. But the biggest thing that was nice about Firefox is that from a privacy perspective, you got way more privacy from Firefox than you ever could get from Chrome or Edge. There is no big brother watching everything you do on Firefox. You have the opportunity to actually implement some security things on Firefox and know that you're not being monitored. If you go into private mode, which is basically like incognito mode, you know that there isn't anybody following what you're doing because there is no organization to benefit from the sale of your data, because that's not what they do. But what if you had a browser that literally not only didn't track anything that you did, but actively prevented all things from tracking you that it could possibly protect you from, and had all the features of a modern browser, like passwords? See, like the DuckDuckGo browser does all these things, except it doesn't have any of these modern conveniences like passwords, bookmarks, things like that. It's a privacy browser with nothing that could compromise your privacy. Well, this new LibreWolf browser has a lot of the features that you'd want in a modern browser, but also takes privacy up to the 99th percentile. So we're going to tell you a little bit about that coming up on the program. Also, how the bad guys use AI to beat your legacy antivirus systems. So if you are running a Norton product, if you're running McAfee, if you're running Malwarebytes, if you're running, what are some of the others, Avast or AVG, for example, if you're running any of those legacy products and your main concern is, have I run my weekly scan? If that's you, these guys with AI systems are going to absolutely eat you for lunch. You are the mark. And the funny thing is, the AI, what it actually does best of all is helps them pass over the more secure people, because they're too hard to get. There's so many suckers out there that you don't need to waste your time on the hard targets. You can go after the soft targets instead. So we're going to talk about that on the program. And finally, all this talk about AI, makes normal people either excited or scared. It's like, that's going to be amazing. Or, oh, we're all going to die in a Terminator-style fiery nuclear death. It seems to be a bipolar camp. You know what I mean? Well, for techies or technical people, they get excited about it because they want to learn how to do it. And I've had people call the program and ask me for suggestions. Where can I go to learn more about how to actually do AI, how to use these AI tools that are out there? Maybe because I own a company, or maybe because I want to implement it in my own workflow, make myself more efficient. Well, now you can learn how to use AI for free from IBM in a 10-hour course that you can take at home in your spare time, individual lessons. And I'm going to actually give you the link to that in the show notes coming up. So if you're not watching at facebook.com/Schrock Innovations, you might want to pop a browser and take a look there, because toward the end of the program here, I'll post the link to that where you can register and get literally 10 hours of free training on how to implement the big level concepts. This is how it works. This is why it works. This is how visual learning works. Then you can understand how it works and you can better understand how to implement that in your life. So if you're a techie person, this is the segment for you. That's why I'm saving it for the end when like the we have two callers left and the music is playing in the background and I'm going to be like, oh, yeah, hey, I posted the link. There it is. So that way you'll be able to get in on the action. 402-558-1110, 888-250-2091. We're going to take our first break of the program, but Bonnie, please stay on the line. Your call is coming up next on Compute This.
Everyone has experienced some form of data loss or knows someone who has. It's unfortunate, but sometimes the technology we rely on simply fails. And the last question you want to hear at that time is, you have a backup, right? When your hard drive, memory card, backup drive, or flash drive fails you, turn to the data recovery experts at Schrock Innovations to get those pictures, songs, and memories back. You know, not all data recovery companies are the same. Having the right tools and knowledge to get the job done right on the first attempt makes all the difference between a successful recovery and the permanent loss of your important data. Sometimes you only get one shot at a successful recovery. That's why Schrock has invested in top-of-the-line recovery imagers, a Class 100 clean environment, over 10,000 donor components, and a staff of recovery engineers that are the best in the business. Schrock has a 96% recovery rate getting data back from failed devices. When the unthinkable happens and you need your data back, turn to the experts at Schrock Innovations for professional and affordable data recovery services.
Now you can configure and purchase laptops, desktops, tablets, and more all at the new ShrockInnovations.com. Check out our specials for one-of-a-kind discounts and deals.
Laptops are subjected to some of the most stressful computing situations imaginable. They get dropped, stepped on, slapped shut, and pushed until the battery dies sometimes. Your laptop works hard for you, so when it has a problem, take it to the laptop experts at Schrock Innovations. Schrock has four convenient service centers in Nebraska and Iowa, with more than 100 total bench spots to get your technology up and running again. Schrock has the largest supply of replacement components in stock, and we fix more laptops than any other nearby repair center. Why wait weeks to get your computer fixed when Schrock can diagnose the problem, provide you with a friendly and accurate estimate, and fix it usually in 2 days or less? Remember, if you have never been into our service centers before, new customers get their first hour of labor free. So the next time your laptop screen gets cracked, the keys pop off your keyboard, or your two-year-old decides a glass of milk is exactly what your laptop needs to cool off, take it to Schrock and let your local laptop repair experts get it back in top shape again.
Alrighty, folks, we are back on Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company. Number to join us on the program today with your questions and comments, 402-558-1110 or 888-250-2091. Quick reminder that our Sophos antivirus is on special at Schrock right now for literally half off. I'm not going to, I don't want to make like a, this isn't a hard sell, okay? I'm going to give you a lot of reasons why that if you can possibly run Sophos instead of whatever you're running now, I'm going to tell you why you should be. But if you don't want to run Sophos, you can choose not to run Sophos. Either way, you're going to end up being a customer eventually. Because if you don't run Sophos, you're going to get hit. And when you get hit, you're going to need help, and we'll be there to help you. And then, of course, we'll say, now that you've been hit and you've paid $240 to get that fixed, would you like to buy Sophos now? Sorry, it's not on sale anymore. It's $160 now. Right now at Schrock in the month of February, it's on sale for half off. Now, there's a coupon code. If you want to do this online, the reason I didn't bring this up originally is when you buy Sophos online from our website, it generates a sale, it charges your card, everything like that. Then someone from our service center needs to contact you to schedule a Schrock desk session to remotely install the software. There's a lot of security reasons why we have to do it this way. I won't get into the weeds on it, but it's not like click here for your download and install the software yourself. We have to configure it. You're paying us to get a better product, not a standard out-of-the-box thing, because you can get that from Norton or whatever. So if you do decide to go to ShrockInnovations.com and go to shop and software and you purchase the Sophos, you can use coupon SOPHOS50, S-O-P-H-O-S-50. We'll take half off the Sophos, brings it down to $80 to the renewal price, literally. So on the other hand, if you just want us to install, you don't want to mess around with buying it online, you can call into the service centers. We're open from noon to 5 on Sunday. Every other day of the week, we're open from 10 in the morning until 8 in the evening. Just give us a call in the service center, And then we can either do the Schrock desk right that minute for you if we have an available technician, or we'll schedule it for, you know, for an hour, half hour later, something like that, and get you taken care of. But it's literally an opportunity that comes around maybe once a year to do something like this. Otherwise, normally it's $160. So if you're one of the people like me that's always complaining about inflation, you know, we have a kiddo that has a lot of allergies and stuff. And so we go through a lot of Benadryl in our house. And when the children's Benadryl is 20% off at Target, you're darn tootin' my wife cleared them out, because that stuff never goes on sale. And we can save 20%. That brings it down to the price it was in 2019. Yeah. Well, the last time that Sophos, that our antivirus product, was $80 a year total, was probably 2010. So if you're like me and you complain about inflation a lot, this is the sale that you need to take advantage of. It is $80 each device. So it's not like you can put it on 900 devices. We'll get into that later on. Bonnie, welcome to the program. Thanks for hanging on the line there. How can I help you on Compute This today?
Okay. I just turned you on. I was listening to you.
Yeah.
And you made the statement that when you have those $25 that you get because you called in and you won the drawing, that you don't need to ask for it. It's automatically applied.
Yes.
There is an exception to that.
What's that?
In December, I'm very pleased with what was put on my computer. The tech came to my house like they do. I'm 76 years old with multiple health problems, and I'm very pleased with the tech. The thing is, Eon, I mean, extremely pleased. He was the best one in my mind that came. But then I wrote a check for the full amount. Then in my email, I got indication that $25 had been applied, and the amount was less than what I wrote the check for. So I called in and I said, "Well, could you send me a check for that?" And then I found out, well, I actually have $50. And no, we can't. If you come out, we can give it to you. Well,
right.
Even when I could drive, even though it's only 10 or 15 miles, it was a problem for me to get out there. And now I no longer drive. And so Moby doesn't go out
did
there.
Did you ever get your $50 back?
No, I never did.
Okay, I will get that taken care of for you, Bonnie. I mean, I see, in my head, I'm going through what you described, and I can see how it happened. The technician on site, for security reasons, our technicians on site can't access our online system outside of a Schrock service center. So if you try to access, like, our customer records, like, you know, your records, if someone was trying to hack us, for example, if you're not coming from an IP address that is an authorized IP address, you literally can't see anything in our backend system. And so when they're at your house is not authorized, so they can't see anything. So they have no way of logging in and looking at your balance, for example, during an on-site. And this is a similar thing to what we had a conversation about in our manager's meeting on Thursday. There was another situation like this where we're on-site and they're like, well, it'd really be nice if we could write invoices on site, because we can't even write the invoice while we're there. We have to, like, call into the service center and have them write it over the phone. If a customer gives us a credit card, we have to tell it over the phone to the service center. They'll apply the credit card. So if they don't go through that, you wrote a check. So they said, oh, I don't have to call anybody. I can just go back to the service center, write it up the invoice, and then put the check on there, and then it applied your credit. So if we were doing a refund, for example, like let's say there was a return and you wanted to get a refund, we can do a check for a refund. We have to wait 14 days just to make sure the original check clears our bank before we send a refund check, and then we send the check out. In this case, you know, I can see, you know, a cash refund for basically what is essentially a coupon. You know, the coupon doesn't have any cash value aside from redeeming services at Schrock, which you tried to do. If you'd have known about it, you would have done it. So, Bonnie, I will go ahead. I've got your phone number here as well. I will make sure that Marissa in Papillion gets a hold of you and gets you that check for $50, because there's no reason to not give you what you earned by calling the program. But I do, I do see how that happened, though. And it's, among other reasons, the technicians have asked me for a way to, you know, be able to access this system remotely, which we're trying to find a way to do it that still maximizes the security, because we don't want data breaches. We don't want to lose our, you know, have our customers say, oh my gosh, you know, I don't want to have the press release where Schrock Innovations, you know, bragging about their Sophos security, got their rear ends breached and lost everybody's data. You know, I don't want to have that press release.
You said that someone's going to call me Monday?
Yes, I'll have Marissa give you a call on Monday and then get it
Please
all straightened
stop
out.
Stop there, because I'll be at work.
Okay.
Oh, can I give you my cell phone number to have them call me?
Yeah, I can put you on hold. Don't give it over the air. Otherwise, you know, there's a lot of guys that listen to this program, and they're all single and lonely. And Bonnie, you sound like a wonderful young lady. And I'm sure that if you drop your cell phone number, you're going to start getting text messages and random pictures. And we don't need to see that, you know. So
every once in a while, I get something like that on Facebook anyway. Okay. So just hang on and then give it after you hang up. Give it to me.
Yeah, we're going
to
put you back on hold. So don't hang up the line there. Thank you for the call, Bonnie. Stay on the line. We'll get your cell phone number and get you all taken care of. I appreciate you giving us a call on the program. 402-558-1110. And ironically, that qualifies Bonnie to win yet another $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate. Amazing stuff, right? So, and that's one of the things about having a local business, guys, or a small business. You know, you have rules that are in place. And these rules that are in place, if it's a Walmart or a Target or something like that, the rules are the rules, and you cannot deviate from the rules. Yeah, if you've called Target and you've scheduled a drive-up order and you come into the store, you cannot pick up your drive-up order inside the store because you need to go to the drive-up spot. I mean, there you go. Yeah, it's ridiculous. Or if you don't pick up your order within a certain number of days or hours, it gets reshelved. But if you call someone and say, you know, my kiddo got sick, I really don't want to come out because I've got a sick kiddo, can I wait till tomorrow? A local small business can say, sure, I understand. They'll put a little note on there that says, hold till tomorrow and write the date. But, you know, the big boys can't do that. And so when we have these rules in place to keep you safe and to keep us safe, to keep your data integrity safe, because we don't want to lose your information. We don't want to get breached. But then something like this happens where that one perfect circumstance hits you that makes all the rules like, we understand why they're there, but we need to bend them a little bit. And each of my employees said, I'm not sure if I can bend that rule. Well, because of this situation, we're going to correct it. I'm going to say, engage the gray matter on this one, guys. She earned $50. She overpaid. Essentially, she wrote us a check for too much money. Now, let's just say she didn't owe $50 and she just added $50 to the check for some reason. And she didn't mean to give Ian a tip. He did a great job. She didn't mean to give him a tip. You know, it wasn't a $50 tip. So how would we handle that? Well, we would obviously refund the $50 overpayment. So let's treat that the same way here. So we'll get you taken care of, Bonnie. 402-558-1110, 888-250-2091. Once again, Sophos is on sale. For a very limited time at Schrock Innovations right now for half off. It's $80 instead of $160. This is an amazing sale, guys. We have never had an $80 coupon on Sophos ever. Never have we ever done that. Even customers who come in who buy it on multiple devices, like I want my phone, my tablet, and my iPad or in my computer, and so that's four devices. Can I get a discount? We don't even give an $80 discount for multi-device installations. We do, but a small discount, but not 80 bucks. Per device. So guys, this is an amazing opportunity. If you do not have Sophos antivirus, this is when you get it. Now you can buy it on our website at schrockinnovations.com. When you're in the checkout, use coupon code SOPHOS50, SOPHOS50, like 50% off, SOPHOS50, to give you that $80 discount. Now you can do it that way, but honestly, the easier way to get this special, guys, is to just wait till we're open and give us a call. And then we can remote in and do a Schrock desk, take your credit card over the phone, handle it. The beautiful thing about Sophos is we can install it and administer it anywhere in the country. So if you're listening to this program right now and you're not in Omaha, Lincoln, West Des Moines, or surrounding areas, you're like, gosh, I wish I had a Schrock in the Villages down here in Florida. Well, guess what? Over the Schrock desk, we can be in the Villages. If you're saying, I wish we had a Schrock in Oregon, guess what? We're in Oregon. If you're saying, I wish we had a Schrock in Grand Island, I know you're listening. Well, there you go. We can do this over the Schrock desk and we can keep your computer safe. Definitely take advantage of this deal, guys. All right. When we come back, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, a couple weeks ago, we talked about this Firefox browser that is dying. My favorite browser is dying. Also, how do the bad guys beat your current antivirus systems? And like I mentioned before, if your biggest concern with your antivirus is when did my last weekly or monthly scan run? Is my antivirus working? Let me check and see. We have people who call us about Sophos. Our Sophos is broken. My monthly scan never, I haven't run a scan since June of last year. What's up with that? This stuff is garbage. Well, because weekly or monthly scans, guys, don't do anything anymore. So why would we waste your computer's resources and beat the snot out of your solid-state hard drive, literally ruining your drive, by uselessly scanning your files for things that aren't there when there's a way better way to do it. Well, if you have Norton, McAfee, AVG, any of those, they're still scanning your hard drive every week or every month, which is literally throwing hundreds of dollars of wear and tear annually on your computer. And you don't need to do it. We're going to tell you why coming up next on Compute This.
Remember the good old days when virus detection worked like Where's Waldo? Spot the virus in the striped shirt and you win. Today's infections are changing hourly to avoid detection and use social engineering to trick you into making mistakes. Using yesterday's security to defend against today's threats is like using leeches to stop an infection. It just doesn't work. We recommend Sophos Intercept X, antivirus backed by Schrock virus-free guarantee. Sophos uses the power of AI to detect the patterns of a virus attack and responds with Schrock custom actions that stop it fast. With Sophos on your PC, Mac, Android, or iOS device, you get the state-of-the-art protection you need to defend against the most advanced attacks out there. In fact, if your device gets a virus while running Sophos antivirus, Schrock will remove it for free, guaranteed. It hasn't happened yet, and we intend to keep it that way. Ditch your dad's antivirus and keep your device, data, and identity safe with Sophos and Schrock Innovations.
Today's fragile computers need maintenance more than ever. Your computer needs a maintenance checkup every 6 months to last beyond its 18-month expected lifespan.
You know your computer needs modern antivirus, and you know using a VPN helps protect your identity online. But did you know that all of that protection could be useless if you're running outdated programs? We all run common free software like Adobe Reader, Dropbox, Firefox, and Chrome. Every day, there are critical security updates for these common programs that don't get automatically installed for up to 2 weeks. That's an eternity in today's world. That's why Schrock created Secure Updater. Secure Updater checks for and installs these critical updates every 8 hours, boosting your antivirus by closing off attack vectors before they can be used to penetrate your computer. Go to SecureUpdater.com and try it for free. We are so confident in our product, we don't even ask for a credit card to start the trial. Go to SecureUpdater.com today and start your 14-day trial and enjoy having the peace of mind that your software is being updated quickly and safely. You will be shocked at the number of programs that are out of date on your PC right now. Get your 14-day free trial at SecureUpdater.com.
Alrighty, guys, welcome back into Compute This. My name's Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company, 402-558-1110, 888-250-2091. Boy, the questions are coming in fast and furious at facebook.com/Schrock Innovations. We're broadcasting live there. If you use the Book of Faces, you can watch the show if you want to. Today, I felt like wearing a T-shirt. I didn't want to put on the whole shirt with the collar, so I put on my Schrock T-shirt, the one that I'd wear in the service center if I was working. And I get a question on here, are the Schrock T-shirts available for purchase? The answer is yes and no, Marla. No, the shirt that I'm wearing right now is not available for purchase. Our official uniform shirts are not available for purchase. A lot of reasons for that, kind of like why UPS drivers have to turn in their uniform after. Imagine if they had UPS uniforms floating around out there. People could masquerade as UPS drivers, and that wouldn't be cool. Weird white vans rolling around with UPS looking guys in there. Yeah, if a UPS driver comes up to you in a UPS uniform and he has white socks on, you know he's a fraud because they actually issue brown socks to go with the brown uniform. So anyway, but we do have T-shirts in the service center, and officially they are free. What we tell customers, or what we tell our employees, is when you have a customer that has been a long time customer, like Ed and Papillion. Or Ken, you've got these customers like Carolyn, for example, who have been with us for years and years and years, have bought laptop, desktop, all these things from us for years and years, and they happen to come in for any reason. If you recognize who they are, give them a free T-shirt. And the lovely Kimberly made a special T-shirt design that is on a gray background. The shirts are so nice, actually, that my employees were upset with me. It's kind of funny because you can't please everybody. No, you can't have my black shirt. But hey, employee, no, you can't wear the customer shirt to work because it's not a uniform shirt. It's by design. It's a wrong color. It's a special design just for customers to wear. Lovely Kimberly did all the research. What do people want in a T-shirt? What's the right blend? What's the right size combination to have in the service center for the average American. We have all the different sizes there. So if you're a longtime Schrock customer, you can come into the service center and just say, hey, can I get one of those T-shirts? And they will give you a free T-shirt. So yes and no is the answer there. 402-558-1110, 888-250-2091. So Firefox is losing market share, and as a result, websites aren't being tested to run on Firefox anymore because it's only 2% of the market share. So while most websites will work on Firefox, some you actually have to go back to Chrome to use because they just aren't tested on Firefox and they have glitches and problems and things like that. There's a new browser out there called LibreWolf that's supposed to focus entirely on privacy. Now, you might be familiar with like the Duck browser. The Duck browser, very much like DuckDuckGo, is a privacy-focused browser, and it's stripped out all the add-ons. So in other words, it prohibits almost virtually all tracking. It anonymizes all kinds of things. It prevent you know, you can't save passwords in it. You can click a little flame button and it literally nukes everything that the browser knows about you. So it's like a clean slate again. It's designed to maximize privacy by giving the browser zero trust. The LibreWolf browser, which is brand new, it's actually a fork of Firefox. So somebody took the Firefox base code and they have forked it off into a new browser. Now, LibreWolf keeps all of those features in that you want to have in a browser, like a password manager and things like that, but it also prohibits you from making stupid decisions about your security. For example, let's say you want to set your default search engine to Google because you value your privacy. You're running a privacy browser. Why in the seven earths would you set Google to be your default search engine? Because you have no privacy with Google. Whenever you use a Google product, you're giving away everything, everything that you do. So LibreWolf doesn't let you do that. Nope, that's right. You cannot select Google as a default search provider. It's not in the list. Nor is Bing. All you have are the privacy engines for options, like DuckDuckGo. That's who your search engine is. Because that's the only way they can guarantee your privacy. Now, like other privacy-focused browsers, websites will break sometimes when you use LibreWolf. The reason they're breaking, though, isn't because they're not supported or not tested. It's because some websites rely so heavily on cookies and things like that, like shopping websites, for example, that they don't work in a private environment. So to give you the basic description, running LibreWolf is pretty much like running an incognito browser all the time, from everybody, and you use this for your most sensitive online needs. You use this for your online banking. You use this to pay your bills. You use this to do credit card things. If you're going to go, you know, play around on Facebook, you can use Chrome for that, or you can use Edge for that, or whatever you want to use, and they'll all work just fine, but you wouldn't want to use LibreWolf there because things may not work they may not work right. Literally, when you click a link in LibreWolf, have you ever seen those links where it's like, you click on it and it shows up at the top and it's like got a ref equals, campaign, blah, 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 blah. It tells you all this information stored in the URL. So every time you click on something, it knows how you got there. LibreWolf knows what that is and strips it all away from the URL. So it literally is removing tracking in real time. So it's a pretty interesting browser. I've been playing around with it. I like it, but it's up to you. But if you want to try out a new private browser, I'd recommend taking a look at LibreWolf. 402-558-1110, 888-250-2091. Keith, welcome to the show. How can I help you on Compute This today?
Well, I came in on the show when you were just finishing up the Sophos antivirus thing. And then when I called in to get clarification, you were just finishing up the Sophos explanation. So can I buy that, not only even though I'm up to date with Sophos here just recently, can I buy it for the future?
Great question. So what we are essentially doing by reducing the price from 160 down to 80, when you first buy Sophos, we have to get you signed up with Sophos, like actually with the Sophos company, get you set up in the system to track your computer and all the technology that's involved in that. So when you sign up, you're paying essentially an $80 registration fee to get started on that device, plus the $80 annual subscription. So that's where we get the $160. What we're doing with this sale is we're basically waiving the setup fee. So you're still paying the $80 annual subscription price, $79.99. So essentially, and I just had this question on Facebook as well. The price is the same as a renewal. So if you're talking about can I buy an extra year of Sophos on the sale price is the same as the renewal price that you would pay. So you wouldn't want to buy that ahead of time. Keep the time value of your money. You'd want to hang on to that till the end of your subscription and then renew. So if you already have Sophos on a device, this sale doesn't do anything for you. If you have devices that you have not protected yet, like cell phones, tablets, things that you hadn't really thought you needed antivirus on, but you darn well do, or other computers, or maybe you have a kid off at college, things like that, then you can add those devices on and it waives all the setup fees. And it's a really neat deal.
Got it. All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks for the call, Keith. I appreciate it. Larry, you're next up on the show. How can I help you on Compute This?
Yeah, good morning, Thor.
Good morning.
But say I've got a pair of holiday special desktop and a laptop, and then my third computer is a $200 Hewlett Packard laptop that is not protected by any antivirus that I'm aware of. Is that a back door in for the bad guys to get into my my computer?
To get into the network, potentially, yeah. So what happens is if you have any device on your network that is not protected by antivirus, if bad guys get access to that device and there is another vulnerability in the network somewhere, for example, if you have a wireless router that's not running the latest firmware, which a lot of people don't know to update their firmware on their router, or if you have a wireless router that's more than 5 years old that's reached end of life and is no longer supported, then the bad guys can get access to that firewall or that router through the unprotected computer, and then they can do an attack on your network from that point. Each individual device on your network should be protected by what we're calling an endpoint protection product. That the endpoint on the network is the computer you're using. That's what Sophos does. There are other layers of protection. If you're in an environment where maybe you're working from home or you're dealing with sensitive information, we have like home firewalls, like hardware firewalls, the little boxes. They're not super expensive, way cheaper than a corporate firewall. But do the same thing. They even have a little app associated with them that allows you to, like, if you have a kid and you want to, hey, it's past midnight, why aren't they up here yet? You can just turn off gaming, and it turns off all gaming features on your network but leaves everything else intact. It's kind of fun. You can blow up their whole world. You can turn off social media. Everything else keeps running, just it kills all social media. So it's kind of neat. But there's all kinds of security products. But to answer your question specifically, yes. If you have an unprotected endpoint on your network, it gives a foothold, basically, for an attack to happen on your network, but it would require some other vulnerability as well to gain access to the network fully, if that makes sense.
Okay, yeah. Hey, one more question. I'm always getting a pop-up on my cell phone saying, this person is on Facebook. The other day it said John Glenn was on Facebook. I can assume my name's coming up on other people's devices. Is there a way for me to shut that down?
You know, those are push notifications from the Facebook app. The easiest way to ensure that you don't get those, number one, in the Facebook app, you can disable, or in the permissions for Facebook, so if you go into your settings and look up notifications, it'll give you a thing where you can select like the Facebook app and disable notifications just for that app. So then nothing will pop up from Facebook. So if you get messages, if you get conversations, things like that, people message you, it won't pop up and bother you. It's also not going to pop up with rando friend requests. The funny thing about Facebook, thanks for the call, Larry. If you don't use Facebook for like a couple weeks, they'll start to email you like, you're missing things out. You're missing out. They want your eyeballs back. So it's kind of funny to ignore them and see what happens. 402-558-1110. We're going to take our final break. But before we go to break, guys, AI is an amazing tool. And AI is being used by the good guys, like Sophos, to help keep your computer safe. AI is also being used by the bad guys to attack computers that are vulnerable out there. So the AI itself, it's not like there's a Skynet Terminator intelligence that is hunting and seeking and destroying your computer and battling day in and day out with your Sophos antivirus in a battle of wills to take control of your technology. If you're running something like Sophos, the bad guys don't screw with you. They literally pass you over like it's Easter and you've got lamb's blood on your door. They just go right over your house. They don't even stop. They go to the next house that's running Norton. And they just huff and puff and blow that sucker up. I mean, it is, not to mix my metaphors here, but it's bad, okay? So the artificial intelligence that's being used out there right now by the bad guys is being used for target selection and also to up the quality of the wetware attacks. What's a wetware attack? That's when you get tricked. And I've got a specific example of a customer that that had a situation this week, had Sophos on their computer in this situation this week, almost got compromised in a wetware attack, and then what happened after that to protect not only that customer but every other customer in our system. This is why you want the corporate version of Sophos and not the home version. Because if you have the home version, everything up to the point where the customer calls us, all the protections that happen after that, you don't get them. I'm going to tell you that story coming up next on Compute This.
There are enough unused computers in storage to give every man, woman, and child in the U.S. an old, outdated, and useless computer system. Obsolete tablets and smartphones are nearly as bad. Most people know not to throw them into the landfill where they leak and contaminate, but it's hard to find a place to safely recycle electronics. That's why Schrock Innovations offers free recycling for computers, laptops, phones, tablets, cords, and accessories. In fact, only monitors and printers have a small recycling fee. Everything else is free. More importantly, Schrock will securely delete any data from your devices and hard drives before they are sent to a certified recycling partner who will then repeat the wiping process just to be safe. When you recycle your old technology at Schrock, you know your identity and privacy are protected and your equipment is being actually recycled by a certified recycling partner. Schrock is proud to recycle more e-waste than we produce annually, making a positive difference to our economy and ecology. Do your part by dropping your old gear at any Schrock service center and be part of the area's largest and most popular technology recycling program with Schrock Innovations.
Schrock Innovations can't teleport technicians to you, but online help is only a click away with the Schrock Desk. Subscribe today and get unlimited help whenever you need it.
You would probably rather drink the water at Camp Lejeune than get another call about the desperate need to renew your car's expiring warranty. Who actually responds to those calls? Everyone wants to play the warranty game where you pay money now just in case you need service later that everyone hopes you won't need or use. It's such a waste. It's no different with computers. Major manufacturers' warranties have more subscript crosses than a Sunday morning church service. Batteries are exempt, hard drives must be completely dead, and forget about anything that they can remotely claim as physical damage. That's why Schrock warranties are different. When you purchase a modular PC or a solid-state laptop and extend your warranty, we offer a no-risk, money-back guarantee. If you need the warranty, you will be thrilled to have it. If you don't use it, we refund your money automatically every time. That's right. We are so confident in the quality of our products that our extended warranties are refundable. Many Schrock customers use their refunds to purchase another warranty or pocket the savings and move on. We all know you'll need it to cover that expiring car warranty anyway. Schrock's refundable extended warranties. Just another way the Schrock Innovations Computer Company makes your computer work for you.
Alrighty, guys, final segment of Compute This. Thank you for sticking with us through the hour here. I appreciate you being here, getting up early, the whole bit. Me too, you know. I don't know what it is. I never sleep good the night before a Compute This program. I'm always, like, during the aftershock, I'll actually start yawning because I'm like, I use up all my energy on the show. And the aftershock, I'm like, hey, guys, how's it going? You know, I'm so tired. I don't know why. I think it's because I know I need to get up early. And so then you're laying there. It's like, I have to get to sleep. And you're worried about getting to sleep. So then you don't fall asleep. And then you have to get up early. So it's weird. All right. So we're going to jump in here really quick. Marcia, stay on the line. Your call's coming up next here. One of the things I wanted to mention during the aftershock, the show we do after this one, as you might remember, I gave a talk on Friday to the Omaha Empowerment Breakfast. It's a networking event of business people, basically, from the Omaha metro area. It was a well-received talk. I was pleasantly surprised. I mean, I was like, this is how Donald Trump feels, right? Because, like, we had an overflow crowd going out of the room into the the lobby outside the room that we were in. So we were over capacity. There's a whole room full of optimists there. I'm like, raise your hand if you think the economy is going to be in a better place 2 to 8 years from now than it is now. And every hand in the room but one went up. And I said, I think you're all wrong. Let me tell you why. And let me tell you what you can do about it. Because, yeah, so good or bad, however the economy goes, you can sit and whine about it or you can do something. So I'm going to go over that coming up on the aftershock here. We'll, of course, talk a little bit more about the Sophos sale. And, you know, we'll cover some Biden bombs. You know, see what we can figure out there, what got hit and why and how and if it did any good at all. All right, let's jump into the phones. Marcia, final call of the program. How can I help you on Compute This today?
Hi, Thor. Thanks. Hey, I just bought a new MacBook, and I have Sophos on my old MacBook, and I need to migrate the two, but I'm not quite sure how. Can I turn off Sophos?
Nope.
Myself?
Nope.
Okay.
And there's a reason for that. One of the first things the bad guys will do is ask you to turn off your antivirus. So we don't let you do that unless you call us and get a code and turn it off. When you call in to get that code, you'll say, I'm migrating it. And we'll say, that's great. The program will migrate, but your services will not. So what we need to do is we need to actually remove Sophos from the old Mac. And then once you have your new Mac set up, we can do a Schrock desk and get you installed on the new Mac. And so,
okay.
So we can move it. We don't charge anything to move it. So it's free. But that's just give us a call when you're ready to make that move, and we're happy to help you do that.
Well, thank you so much. I appreciate it, and I appreciate Sophos. Thank you.
Hey, no sweat, Marcia. Thank you for the call. So we had a customer this week in the service center, guys. One of the things that our Sophos does is it blocks third-party remote access tools except for the Schrock desk. There's a new third-party remote access tool, brand new on the market. And the bad guys are using that to access computers because it's not on the blacklist yet. Sophos doesn't automatically block it. So a customer calls in. They said, well, I let this guy remote into my computer, and he's trying to do stuff, but Sophos kept blocking what he was doing. So he tried to turn off my Sophos, but he couldn't turn it off. So then he tried to remove my Sophos, but it asked for the removal code, and I didn't have that. And, you know, so he calls us to get the removal code. And we're like, well, can I ask, you know, well, of course we'll give you the removal code. It's your computer, but can I ask why you're doing it? And he says, well, I got this guy remoted in from such and such support. And we're like, holy schnike, hold on a second. How did you hear about, you know, what's going on? Found out that this is a scammer that's trying to take advantage of this guy. And Sophos literally saved him from a wetware attack by not having the access to those immediate things and having to call us to basically explain what was going on so we could make sure he stayed safe. Now, here's the kicker. Now what we can do is we can add this new remote access software to our internal Schrock group policy blacklist, and now every one of our customers is protected from that attack automatically from now on. The bad guy won't even get remoted in. That's AI-powered tech, guys. It allows the humans to focus on the high-level stuff, and the automated stuff happens automatically. There's no need for weekly or monthly scans because everything is scanned every time it loads. So if they load the virus, it gets blocked. If it's sitting on your hard drive idle, then a scan every couple months will find it. It's not a big deal. All right, so today's winner, $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate, is Keith. Congratulations, Keith. Marissa will get a hold of you here on Monday to get that certificate into your Schrock account. Do stay tuned for the After Schrock coming up here. Give me about 5-6 minutes to get reset, and we'll go over everything there. Sale right now on Sophos. If you're just tuning in, Sophos is the AI-powered antivirus solution. It is literally, arguably, number one or number two in the world for keeping your computer safe. And it's on special for half off at Schrock. It's $80 instead of the normal $160. It is a huge sale, guys. This is another experiment. We've never done this sale before. If it works out, great. If it doesn't, we'll never do it again. But you can order online, coupon code SOPHOS50, or it's sometimes easier just to give us a call in the shop. Thanks for joining us, guys. We'll talk to you here in a bit for the Aftershock and see you next weekend for another edition of Compute This. From the